Hello and welcome to this video. This is a series that will guide you through the process of animating Genesis figures from Daz Studio within Blender using Rig-GNS. In this segment, I will shed more light on some of the issues you might encounter while exporting Genesis figures from Daz Studio to Blender. First, let's start by loading a figure. In the Smart Contents pane, go to Figures and select Genesis 8 Basic Mill. I will go ahead and double click the underbelly morph and then click accept. Next, I will go to wardrobe and add this bodysuit and add this pants as well and then these boots. Now, to export the figure, make sure you check in the scene pane that you have the figure selected. Now, in the file menu, you'll find three export options that can be used to export this figure to Blender. The first one is the standard built-in export option that's already included with Daz Studio. The other two options are from Diffeomorphic, but you'll need to install the plugin to access them in this file menu. And additionally, there's a Send To option which reveals the Daz to Blender bridge, and that is what I'll be using. Now, clicking it will bring up the export window, and I usually don't mess with these advanced settings. I just make sure I have the right version of Blender selected, which at this point is Blender 3.6. I will leave the FBX version as FBX binary and then click accept and wait for that to finish and click OK. Now, let's open Blender. I'm currently using version 3.6.3. Now, I'll open the properties panel by pressing N. But before we go to the Rig-GNS tab, I will first open the Daz to Blender tab here, which is the Daz add-on for Blender, of course. And by simply clicking on Import New Genesis Figure, it locates the file that was just exported from Daz and load it. Now I will just delete this default cube, select the rig, and now make my way to the Rig-GNS panel. Here I am working with version 3.7. Now within the panel, you will spot the Convert to GNS button. A single click on this button performs an automatic conversion of the rig. Now after the conversion, it is good practice to verify that the meshes are deforming properly, so I will switch to pose mode and proceed to rotate some of the bones. We can see that the pants and the boots respond correctly. So now I'll switch to object mode and begin the rigging process by adding a meta rig. However, you may encounter an error message stating cannot execute. This figure cannot be rigged due to disparity in vertex order. Some added items might have altered the figure's mesh. To enable the fixed rigging button, without removing the current figure from the scene, import another plain replica of the figure. Now, let me go back to Daz Studio for clarification as to what this message means. So, the message indicates that we need to import a simplified version of the figure into Blender. So now, I will expand the items in the scene pane, then select all objects except the hip, which is a part of this figure. Once they are highlighted, I will press delete key, leaving us with just the plain figure. Now, to export this figure, go to File. Select the standard built-in export option this time. It's important to set the save as type to Autodex FBX. You can also give the file a new name. I will call this underbelly and then click save. I've covered this export option in previous videos and you can refer to the user guide for more detail. So once everything is set, click accept. Now in Blender, to load the figure, use the Rig-GNS import button, which is this large button. Navigate to the folder where you have it saved, select it, and then click import Genesis figure. As soon as the figure is imported, you'll notice the fixed rigging button in the panel. Click on it and it will automatically add a meta rig and match the rig. Next, click generate rig and then the rig figure button. Great, now we have the figure fully rigged. Once more, let's quickly verify that everything is deforming as expected. Alright, so now let's switch to object mode and move this figure to the side on the x-axis. Let me also enable the screencast case so you can follow along with the key presses I make on my keyboard, which will be displayed in the corner of the screen. The reason I move the figure to the side is to create space in the middle of the scene for importing another figure. Now let's return to Daz. and delete the previous figure. Still in the Figures tab, I'm going to load Genesis 8 female this time around. I will then go to Wardrobe and dress her up. I will also add hair to the figure. Now, the next step after making sure the figure is selected in the scene pane is to go to File. This time we're using the option provided by Diffeomorphic. I believe the option below is for high definition meshes, but I typically use the first option. But before selecting Export to Blender, we'll have to save the project. And the project needs to be saved before you can use the Export to Blender option. So I will go ahead and click Save and save the project as Genesis 8 Female Fighter, and then click Save and Accept. Once the project is saved, I'll go to File and now select Export to Blender, and with the same name, I will again click Save. So with that exported, I'll press OK and switch to Blender. You will need to have the Diffeomorphic Blender add-on installed to have this Daz setup. Now I'll open its panel and then click Import Daz. Navigate to the folder where the DUF file is exported, select it, and then click Import Daz. You might encounter this message about an invalid mesh, but I often ignore it and just press OK. Next, I'll go to the Rig-GNS panel and click Convert to GNS. Alright, and so to ensure the meshes are in order, we'll go to Pose Mode and move the bones to check for abnormalities. Since everything appears to be fine, I prefer having the viewport shading as texture matcap. It appears what should have been the pant has been matched with the figure skin. Now let's investigate this further. I will select this part and switch to local view. Yeah, it appears the pants got combined with the figure, and I don't think this will work, so let's go back to global view and undo everything to remove this figure from the scene. Now let's try a different export option, so return to Daz, and once again I'll go to File, select the standard export option, rename the file to Genesis 8 Female Fighter, click Save and click Accept. Now let's head back to Blender. Always ensure to use the import button within Rig-GNS panel for figures exported from Daz using the standard built-in export option. So here is the figure we just exported. Now I'll select it and then click Import Genesis Figure. Now let's proceed to rig the figure. But before we do that again, we're going to check if there's a problem with the meshes. So I'll switch to Pose Mode, select one of the bones and rotate it. Okay, now the pant is not deforming with the bone. So let's see how we can fix that. I'll go to Object Mode. I will select the pant. And as anticipated, the modifier panel reveals that there is no armature modifier assigned to this pant. However, before adding armature modifier, it is important to verify whether the pants have vertex groups. So I will go to Vertex Properties panel. And you can see there are no vertex group assigned to this pant. So now I will select the figure and then hold down the shift key and select the pant as well. I will then focus on just the selection by switching to local view. Now to transfer vertex group from this figure to this pant, I will head over to weight paint mode. In the weight tab, select transfer weights and then expand this option down here. Here change the source layer to by name. This immediately reveals some vertex group here in the vertex group panel. And for more precision, slightly increase the ray radius to around 0.2. Now holding down the left mouse button on this sample width reveals the sample vertex group. Now this will display a heat map representing different vertex groups depending on the area of the pants I click on. Okay, now that we have created the vertex group for the pants, let's return to object mode and then global view. With the pan selected, I will add an amateur modifier. But instead of going to the modifiers panel, here's another way. Select the pan, then hold down shift and click the amateur to have it selected as well. Now press Ctrl P and choose parent using empty groups. We should see that an amateur modifier is now applied. So let's test it again by posing a bone. And we should see that the pants now deform correctly. All right. Now in object mode, let's proceed with the rigging process by clicking add meta rig, then match rig, then generate rig, and then rig figure. So with the figure now fully rigged, for the last time, I will check to see whether everything is deforming correctly. And again, it appears the pants was not properly rigged. Let's fix that by selecting the pants and checking the modifier panel. Yeah, the problem is because no amateur is linked to this object field. I will delete this existing modifier. Then while holding shift, select the rig and press Ctrl P, select with empty groups. And this should correctly link the pants to the rig. We can see that here in this object field. And to enhance deformation, you can enable preserve volume. Now switching to pose mode, I will move this bone and we can now see the pant is now deforming as it should. So that wraps up this section. In the next part, we will dive into animating these figures using the Animixer tab here. So if you found this video useful, please give it a like. Thank you for your time. Till next time.